So we'll mute and remove.
Dr. Smita, you are mute.
Now, right. Yes. Namaskar, namaskar, namaskar. My dear friends and my family members, today we will be talking to you about hypothyroidism. We have done this live also last year actually when there was lockdown. But lots of people are always asking, kyunki thyroid, hypothyroidism is like an epidemic. And once it comes to you, and you start taking some kind of a remedies or chemical medication from the doctors, you have to practically take it for whole of your life. And it only keeps on increasing, the dose is increasing. And the other part is that people are still getting symptoms of inflammation, swollen feeling, gas, bloating feeling, constipation, palpitation, tiredness, chronic fatigue, joints pain, all of these symptoms are still there. Although their thyroid results are normal in the lab analysis, but in spite of that, they still suffer. So this subject, I thought, is something that we must take in the interest of humanity. And my purpose of life is to help everybody to get healthy. And we have helped Ayushakti. As you know, it's 34 years old chain of clinic across the world, started by me and my late husband, Dr. Pankaj Naram, together. And only with the interest of helping people to become successful practitioner and helping practitioner to help thousands and hundreds of people on this planet. So thyroid, we have around in our file, because we keep all the records very systematically, more than 50,000 people suffering from autoimmune thyroid worldwide we have treated successfully. And in terms of success, what you can experience is if it's early stage of thyroid, then you can actually prevent need to take the medication and you can get out of it completely. And you don't even have to take herbal formulas and everything forever in your life. If you are in the middle of already taking some medication chemicals from the doctors, and there is a severe antibody which is attacking the thyroid gland. With this, what we will share today, and I will share with you real stories which had such a success, you will feel so inspired looking at them, because to reduce antibody, there is nothing in modern medicine. So because of the antibody, even if you take thyroid medication, your thyroid gland is going to get shrunk. And because of that, your doses are only going to get increased day by day. So we will discuss with you how you can take care of that, how you can prevent that from happening. And sometimes thyroid also is happening because of the side effect of hyperthyroid medication. So we will even discuss that. And I will actually share real stories from different parts of the world today. And trust me, these stories I am sharing only because you can understand how Ayurveda ancient healing can work. But before we start, I would like to pay respect to my lineage. As you know, we practice 2,700 years old lineage, which was started originally by Vaidya Amoghapatra, whose student was Vaidya Jivaka, who actually Vaidya Jivaka was the main head of the lineage, because he actually literally trained hundreds of pulse readers and detox specialists in the world, who then trained their students. And now from whom we learned was 124 years old. That's how much he lived up to. Babaji, we called him our master. So me and my late husband, Dr. Pankaj Naram, we both actually learned from him, and I did learn something from my husband as well. So my respect to them today, with a prayer that whatever we say today will create a difference in people's life. That's my commitment. You must get some difference in your life by listening to what I'm talking today. And one more good news, we have today with us Dr. Archana Vardhan, who is actually joined us right from USA, right from Virginia, which is far away from here. So you can see in the background, there's darkness because it's still dark there. It's early morning. And thanks for joining, Dr. Archana, because I know that your children are just about to go to school and you just took out time to share your experience and talk to the people how we can take care of this situation. Dr. Archana is actually connected with Ayush Shakti and she is one of the certified practitioners. So if you are in USA, you can definitely call her. We will be sharing her numbers. And but before that, what happens when there is thyroid? If there is hypothyroid, then there are symptoms. Ritika, yes. There are symptoms like tiredness, dry hair, hair loss, severe head, joints pain, stiffness, swelling, fatigue, constipation. In fact, people who get thyroid, they also sometimes have a history of IBS in the past. Breathing problems, mood swings, very slow heart rate, or sometimes even fast heart rate. So there's like urethmia, irregular heart rates. And TSH gets high and T3, T4 gets low. That's the time that the doctor says that you have to take the thyroid medication. So I want to invite Dr. Archana to share her own experience, which was the beginning stage of thyroid and what she did. And then I would want to share how we work in thyroid condition, what is our philosophy? Because we don't work on a symptom, we work on a root cause. So I'll just share that.
Thank you, Dr. Smita, for bringing me on this platform. It is a great pleasure to be with you. So as we all know, thyroid gland is a very important endocrine gland. It helps in metabolism and various other bodily important functions. So my story started with, like, I started having hair fall. And then my metabolism was kind of disrupted and I was having loose stools on and off, it was going on. But I was kind of ignoring. I was like, I didn't think of that I would have a thyroid problem. I was thinking, okay, I just delivered a baby. Maybe the iron deficiency or all other stuff are leading to this. But then I went for my health checkup and there it was, my borderline thyroid TSH was high. I was kind of surprised and shocked. And this was kind of getting me on head that if I come on thyroid medication, it will be forever. So I didn't want it to be. And you can see as in my results, it was 4.29. And what happened, my doctor gave me like 3 months grace period. She was like, whatever you can do in 3 months, we will repeat your test. So I had like 3 months to correct myself. I was like, no, I have to do it. So since I have been with Ayush Shakti and I know their herbs are really good. So I started with Fiberon and Metabosin. Metabolism was also disrupted. And yes, I completely changed my diet. I was off gluten. I was completely avoiding soy and its products. I was on Moong diet, goitrogenic foods and everything. And then I used to see the labels behind. Like I used to read, like, does it have sugar or soy? Because most of the products as a preservative, they have soy in it. So by, you know, in those 3 months, I came to know even the bread, you know, you see that it is gluten free, but still you see there is soy in it. So yes, wrong lifestyle, wrong diet was the reason. And there was a lot of AMA production and kapha, basically it kind of got obstructed. So I had to correct it. And then I went on diet, I went on the herbs suggested. And then I spoke to like one of the doctor over in Ayush Shakti, Dr. Ronak. So he kind of guided me, okay, go ahead with this. So yes, and then after 3 months, I got my results corrected again. And then you can see like in previous slide, it was so shown that before like 3 months, I got 4.29. And after 3 months of diet correction and herbs, it came to 2 point something. So it gave me a big
the normal range.
Yes,
and the normal range.
Yeah, it gave me a big relief. And yes, again, a big confidence to practice Ayurveda and to follow Ayurveda.
Amazing. You have more power now and more responsibility to help lots of people using this wisdom, actually. So that was amazing, Dr. Archana, that you came to share this experience with us today. So as Dr. Archana said, you know, wrong diet, wrong lifestyle, particularly the preserved food, heavy food, mucousy food like red meat, wheat, milk products, all of these things, when you take a lot and you are not exercising, it then ends up in creating what we call it, depleting the agni. So digestion is impacted first, and then toxins are produced. So Ayurveda always talks about ama, kapha, and pitta toxins. So people who are new to Ayurveda, they can think it as a mucousy toxins which are coming from undigested food. So when the food are not digested, there are three kinds of toxins. One is watery toxins, which we expel from the kidney, fatty toxins, which stays in the liver and we expel from the liver, and then undigested food remains in the colon and the intestinal area. And as Dr. Archana said, there was a loose stool and all this digestive issue. This is the starting point of actually getting toxins accumulated. So that confirmed that it begins from the gut. And from there, it spreads and it settles in the thyroid gland. And then from there, because these are toxins which are not normal, so it changes the cellular structure in the thyroid gland. So immune system thinks this is something foreign, something bacteria, virus or something. And they begin to attack. This is a normal response to the of an immune system to anything which is not looking natural as it should be. And that's how autoimmune thyroid, or in some cases, this toxin stay in the thyroid gland and inflames the gland, and they have nodules and swollen thyroid, inflammation, and hyperactive thyroid response, because it produces over hormones then. And to remove that, normally chemical medicines are given, and overdose of that ends up into hypothyroidism. But trust me, if you follow the principle that we are going to talk to you, slowly and steadily, you can remove this hyperactivity. Also, you can control it within 2 to 3 months. I've seen that happening naturally. And people don't need to take even Ayurvedic remedies anymore. It just remains very well if you follow the diet later on. So there are three steps. We follow three steps in order to bring back long-lasting result and long-lasting functioning of our thyroid, long-lasting normal functioning of the thyroid. So it doesn't have to depend even in Ayushakti herbs or the diet or anything. So begin first step, as we said, toxins accumulation is very important. So first, go back, Ritika. So first step is remove toxins. So remove toxins which are piled up in the thyroid and in the gut and any other system. So remove blockages and toxins. Second is restore. Repair the thyroid gland because of the toxins and attack from the immune system. The thyroid gland is probably not working very well. Either it is slowed down or it is hyperactive. So restore the normal function and restore the normal immune function as well. And then because of this impact of the toxins and also attack from immune, etc., there is a scar tissue always created, because like we get hurt and we get some kind of a wound on our skin, when it heals, there is a scar which is formed exactly inside our, on the thyroid gland itself also scar tissue is formed. So we do something which is nourishing and renewing thyroid gland, because our own body produces natural fresh cells every day. Millions and millions. So it can create a new fresh cells, and that it takes some time, but cellular transformation is something that is absolutely natural and absolutely possible. It will be done only by you and you only. If you support your body, it will create a new thyroid system. And then once the scar tissue is gone, you don't need anything. Your thyroid is back to working normally. Next one. So in the remove toxins, first step, this is what you can do. There are three types of detox you can do. One, you can do 7 days of home-based detox by yourself. So if you are listening and you have obesity, you have feeling of toxins, you have thyroid situation, just do this 5 to 7 days of diet, which is just based on mung and vegetables only, nothing else. and do this every month till you feel that your body is light, your tongue is not coated with the toxins anymore, and you're losing naturally weight. You're keeping your weight under control naturally. So that's like home-based, you know. But generally, if you want to really get rid of toxins in a very deep manner, then we do recommend two more types of detox, which we do it in the clinic. Next one is healthy meat detox. Now, this healthy meat detox is a 28 days program, which has a specific diet, which changes every day according to the stage of the detox. And our focus is actually to pull out toxins from liver, fatty toxins. So all the bodily fatty toxins accumulates in the liver and goes from there. Water retention goes out from the kidneys, and half digested food goes out from the colon through the loose stool, etc. we do. And the next detox, which is the most powerful one and which is having a definitely sure results in very chronic situation, we call it detox panchakarma, literally, where you have to come to the clinic and do it. That detox actually is having double the impact than healthy meat detox, because it is pulling out, bringing toxins to the gut, and then we remove it using different ways of purgation or vomiting or enema, etc. But this is absolutely done under doctor's guidance. We have actually clinics which does it, like one in Vienna, there's one in Munich, and then there are clinics in Mumbai as well. While this is a resort where actually Western people and people from all over the world come and stay there for 3 weeks. So we have this kind of a setup in Mumbai, Goa, and Germany. So the next step, for which I would like to invite Dr. Archana. This is the real story of patient Laura, whose antibody was, this is from actually Dr. Giovanni, who is an MD medical doctor from Europe. And he practices with Ayush Shakti and Dr. Naram. He practiced for more than 20 years. A very experienced practitioner, very successful. So his patient Laura had antibody before was 532 when they started this whole process where we put her on a detox monthly, then the repair program and the renew program. And after some 1.5 years, it was normal. It came into the normal range completely. It is still normal actually. And we stopped almost 80% of the herbs from Ayush Shakti now. And she's just very well. This is another client from Mauritius who actually traveled up to Mumbai, and she did the detox in Mumbai, staying in the clinic. And she had this thyroid for 4 years and nothing. I mean, she was taking medication. Everything was staying under control from the medication, from the doctor, and still having extreme fatigue, extreme hair fall. Weight was increased like anything. Nothing was helping, not a diet, not an exercise was helping to lose the weight. And she was really tired and very, very frustrated because nothing was working. So we did the detox only with the 3 weeks of deep treatment that she did by staying in the clinic. She lost huge amount of weight. Her hair falling stopped. She increased energy. See, that when you do the detox, you use your own toxins to create energy. And that is how, in spite of detoxifying, she actually felt more energetic. And then slowly her thyroid became so normal that her own doctor actually within 6 months, because we followed all three steps, which I'm going to talk to you. Within 6 months, the doctor stopped her thyroid medication because TSH went down below the normal. So they said that your thyroid is already working now, so we don't need to give any medication because your own body is producing the thyroid hormones. Yeah, Dr. Archana, would you like to take this repair program?
Yeah, so as Dr. Smita mentioned that we have to restore the repair. After repairing comes the restoring of the thyroid gland. So how can you restore the thyroid gland? You can restore the thyroid gland by taking your normal diet, taking proper herbs under supervision of medical Ayurvedic doctor. So by diet, I meant that you have to completely avoid all the refined food. Just like, you know, that short key food people are like, okay, handy, we take, okay, burger, pizza, fries are like, they are the meals which like grab and go feel, and people feel like, okay, I'll finish the meal and I'll go. But you have to completely stop it, because these are the basically building blocks of toxins in your body. And the disease doesn't develop in one day or in one week. It develops over a period of time. And that was happening with me. I was kind of ignoring. I was getting upset digestion, upset stomach, but I was completely going on off diet, and I was completely avoiding everything which was healthy. So please, please avoid wheat. Avoid completely wheat, maida, milk, and dairy products. Fermented food are, because when you're suffering from thyroid gland, usually your gut is also affected. Mainly the problem starts from gut. So the small intestine, the flora, it is already having the bacteria which are in fermented phase. So when you eat a lot of sour food or fermented food, it kind of basically disrupts your intestinal flora. So avoid everything which is sour and fermented. Be on a diet which is wholesome diet, which includes your moong dal, which includes your whole grains. You can have rice, you can have barley. Barley also, I would say, take a limited amount, because it does have a little bit of gluten in it. Bengal gram, cucumber, carrots, and strawberries. Then, yes, protein-rich food have to be taken, which includes beans. Tofu, a little bit is allowed. People say that it's soy and its products are not allowed. Why you have added tofu? You can have anything in moderation. Anything in excess is not good for health. Nuts and figs, goat cheese, egg and fish. Fish, people who are those who are vegetarian, fish is a rich source of selenium. So we have seen that people who suffer from long-term chronic disease of thyroid, they have deficiency of selenium. So they can be achieved by having natural sources through fish and egg. Chicken, protein rich vegetables like broccoli, spinach, and mushroom. Broccoli also you can have, but it should be had in moderation, because it comes in cruciferous vegetables, which are supposed to be avoided during people suffering from thyroid hypothyroidism. Ritika, can I have the next slide, please? Yes. And then, yes, in Ayurveda, it is said that ahar vihar. So ahar, we have taken care of the diet. Now vihar means the lifestyle you are following. So you have to keep your body moving along with the food you're taking. So by movement, we mean yoga. Pranayama, as we all know, that Alom Vilom has been traveling throughout the world and people are following it. So the basic pranayama recommended with people having hypothyroidism is that they should follow Alom Vilom Ujjayi, because it kind of activates thyroid gland. So Ujjayi pranayama is really, really very good in activation of thyroid gland. Ustrasan, which is called as camel pose, Sarvangasan, these all basically stimulate the functioning of thyroid gland. Then we have Shalabhasan, Matsyasan, Bhujangasan, and Shavasan. If you practice all these, I can, with my case, with my experience, I can assure you that if you're in early stages of your hypothyroidism, you can completely reverse the disease, because I did it. If I can do it, anyone can do it. Then I also took, like I mentioned, I took some herbs, which were like Fibron and Meta Boost. So Fibron, it has Kanchanar. And as we all know, Kanchanar and a very good quantity of Gugulu. So this combination of Kanchanar and Gugulu is very useful in eliminating the toxins, in eliminating the inflammation. And Kanchanar itself is useful in reducing the extra growing tumors in the body. So the tumors, I mean the extra growth, it helps. The Kanchanar helps. And then Meta Boost, as we all know, metabolism is affected. So it has Chitra and other herbs, which kind of stimulates and boosts your metabolism. So these two herbs helped me. And I'm sure if you also start taking that, it will help you too. Thank you.
Amazing, amazing, Dr. Archana. You were so inspiring by sharing your own experience that you have already gone through, and you have already controlled and conquered that situation. So we all feel that kind of inspiration in what you are sharing. And my dear friends, you know, if you have any questions, and even the questions not just related with the hypothyroid, but you can ask any questions related to health situation, and we will be so happy to answer them. Please put your question on the comment below, and we will be more than happy to answer them after this session is over. So keep your questions posting there. Now, this is another case study, and you will feel so proud of our ancient science, because this was from Hungary. Her name is Kamala Devi Dasi, but basically local Hungarian, and she is a Hare Krishna devotee. So her name is a spiritual name. And she had a goiter nodule in the left lobe of thyroid. So thyroid, if you get the nodule, it was swollen, literally swollen actually. And you can see here that when she came to see us in 2006, she had like minimum 8 nodules. You can see there are so many of the biggest, there are 3 nodules, but the biggest one was 4.6 centimeter by 1 centimeter by 1 centimeter, which was a really big one. And then other 2 nodules were there. So we did, she stayed in our clinic in Mumbai, and we did the vomiting type of detox under the doctor's guidance. Don't do it by yourself at all. And then purgation therapy and enema, followed by rejuvenation, rebuilding therapy. And she went back home, and you can see that her 2 nodules were gone just in 3 months. And the one which was bigger one is now only 1.4 centimeter by 1.6 centimeter. Then it happened. This is why I wanted to share this with you. She's now completely free from all the nodules for years and years and years. But this is what happened when she bought green mung bean flour from internet somewhere. And you know, green mung bean, we advocate a lot because it's alkaline, it removes toxins, it reduces inflammation, it's very good. So she said, I'll make a mung bean rotis, chapatis, instead of regular gluten-free chapati. She bought it and she started making this chapati, and she ate it for a month. And suddenly her weight increased like anything. And she looked very bloated. She met me and I saw her pulse in Vienna. And I said, you have been exposed to gluten. She said, no way, I'm so strict. And finally, she read the label of the mung bean flour, which had around 20% wheat flour in it, which she didn't realize that it is not a pure mung bean atta. So make sure whenever you eat something, like Dr. Archana said, read the label. Make sure that you are not having any form of gluten, dairy, or fermented food in your diet. And that's how the nodule increased. And finally, we again did one more detox. It went away completely, and she was free from all the nodules in around 2 years' time. So her T3, T4 completely, as you can see, came under control. She had a hyperthyroid because TSH was very, very low. That is the sign of hyperthyroidism. While after the treatment, everything became normal. The thyroid hyperactivity stopped. TSH became normal. T3, T4, which was very, very high, came down to normal. So this is how it is possible that you can actually slowly, if you work on a root cause, you can definitely get a long lasting result in any chronic health conditions. Next one. Yeah. So third stage, as I said, is a renew stage, in which now we want to help our own body to produce the new cells, because body is constantly renewing and creating millions of new cells. Only you need to help it so that the scar tissue is replaced by the new ones. And that is true for even the scar tissue on the face or on burn scar tissue or any part of the body. So this is the renew juice that we recommend everybody to take it. It helps even with the shrunken thyroid gland from autoimmune attack, or even inflamed thyroid, which is shrunken from the hyperthyroid medication or radiation, and there is a scar tissue. That's why the thyroid is not working and you have to take still medication for hypothyroid. So this we tell everybody to take it for whole of their life actually, even if the thyroid gets back to normal, like a maintenance. So carrot juice, take one carrot, a pomegranate, and one beetroot, and make a juice from the juicer and add a teaspoonful of turmeric powder and drink it in the morning. You can even add protein powder. You can add flaxseed, almond, walnut, and just crush it and make it like a smoothie and take it in the morning. Yeah, next one. Yeah, this is one treatment which normally we do it in the clinic, but you can also do it at home. You can see we couldn't actually organize the treatment on the thyroid itself, but we do this pack. You can see on that lady, her forehead, there is a pack. There is a cloth, folded cloth, which we have dipped in the oil. So you can use actually a mixture of sesame oil and ghee. In the clinic, we use actually a nourishing kind of oil, but here you can use also at home just a normal sesame oil and ghee mixed together. Keep it a little bit warm and dip this folded clothes in this oil and put it on your thyroid area on the neck. As you can see here, it is on the forehead. Don't do it on forehead, do it on the neck. And keep it there for 10-15 minutes. When it gets cold, again, put it back into the oil, little warm oil, and then keep that pack again and repeat it until you finish it for 15 minutes. Trust me, this is helping a lot for renewing the organ, especially people who have so this is not indicated when there is a inflammation in the thyroid, but people who have a shrunken thyroid gland, this is very much indicated and you can keep taking it continuously. Yeah. Then we also give, we also give this herbal formula, which is purely nourishing herbal formula. So earlier Fibron and MetaBoost is good enough for the early stage. And it only helps with the balancing and regulating thyroid hormone system and improving metabolism. But when it is a little bit advanced stage, a bit chronic, and you want to reverse it in a step-by-step manner, rebuild your shrunken thyroid gland, then Niramay is very good. And there is another one, which is Ojas. So Niramay is on the left, right side, and the Ojas on the left side. You can read the name. This Ojas or Ayushakti Immuno, we use it for balancing the autoimmune response. And we have seen that 80% cases, antibody gets negative within a year's time. Some people in the early stages, it even becomes negative within 6 months. So that's what is possible. I'm just sharing from my own experience of the clinic. So, you know, it is purely coming from our experience and I'm just sharing how you can work on the root cause. Yeah.
That was great, Dr. Smita and Dr. Archana. We have a few questions here.
There are a few questions. Yeah, tell me, please.
So there is one question from Miss Priya. She says, is thyroid a condition likely temporary or long lasting?
Well, generally, if you don't work on the root cause, it is a long lasting condition. Otherwise, if you work on the root cause, I think in a couple of months or a year or two, it can just go away. So we are here talking about working on the root cause. We are not making a claim that, you know, you can just be a substitute to the doctor's prescription, because we work on the root cause. So as your gland is getting renewed and restored, slowly, steadily, your medication need is reduced and cut down step by step.
Okay, thank you, doctor. There is one more question. How can we diagnose like a person is having PCOS or thyroid? Because more of the time, female gets confused, like if we have PCOS or we have thyroid.
Very good question, actually. So normally thyroid, obesity is something that people feel obese in the thyroid. They get completely overweight. Nothing is controlled. Even the diet or the gym exercise cannot reduce the weight. And same situation is in PCOS. But there are a couple of symptoms which are different. For example, in the thyroid, mostly menstrual irregularity is not the case. So PCOS has always menstrual problem. It can delay your menstruation, or whenever it comes, it's a very, very heavy menstruation. There could be also sometimes migraine. And so these are some symptoms which can differentiate, but the best way is to do the test. So you can do TSH and T3, T4. That will let you know if you have any thyroid imbalance. And for PCOS, because it is a purely polycystic ovarian syndrome, so there are small cysts in the ovaries, which you can absolutely check it out by doing the ultrasound scanning. That can help. Definitely.
Also, Dr. Smita.
Yeah.
Like out of my experience, I've seen that in thyroid, we see hair fall. And in PCOS, there's extra growth of hair. So that's
exactly on the chin. And in the thyroid, hair fall is all over the head. In PCOS, the front line is fading because of the androgenic, the hormone system. And hair is coming on the chin and other areas. Absolutely perfect. Thank you.
So thank you, Dr. Smita and Dr. Archana, for answering all of our questions and being here today on this Facebook Live. We were very glad for you, for both of you, for being today on this live session. So Dr. Archana, if anybody wants to get in touch with you, would you like to just tell us how can we get in touch?
Can you take the slide of her numbers? You know, there was a slide with all the numbers. So we can share these numbers with everybody. So people can call India. If there are people in India, they can call Ayushakti Clinic and meet any doctors on 1-800-266-3001. Out of India, global, any part of the world, you can call this number and you will be in touch with any practitioner which can help you. So 1-800-280-0906. You can even do the WhatsApp on 9177700-1561. So you can send us message on this number on the WhatsApp, and you can even write to us on info@ayushakti.com. Before I forget, I want to just let you know that if you have missed anything which we shared today, we will be reposting this live again, so you can always play it. And if possible, I would request Asmita and Ritika, who are helping us at the back end, thanks for helping us, to put the PDF file as downloadable PDF for the people who have missed this, who want to keep it and follow it continuously. Can we do that? In the description?
Yes, we will surely put that.
Yeah, put it in the description so that you can send it to in their inbox as a whole material which they can use it later on. Dr. Archana, would you like to share your number?
Yes, if people who are in Virginia, they can, or in US, they can contact me 203-308-7128. And then we can talk about like whatever Ayushakti has helped me, I would like to proceed and help through Ayushakti only.
And of course, I mean, our website is www.ayushakti.com, www.ayushakti.com. And you can also follow us on Instagram, Twitter, and even on the YouTube, we have lots of recipes and different videos that you can watch and learn from there. So this was our pleasure that we were there with you. We could share this with you. If you have any questions or any topics that you think we should come up again, please put it in the comment. Then we will be so happy to get back to you with those lives. Normally, every Friday is a time of the live session. And thousands of people later on are watching them. So we'll be happy to share our knowledge with you. Stay happy and stay healthy.
Namaskar.
Namaskar. Namaskar.